Happy morning, children. Welcome to Math Online class. Before beginning today's session, I want you all to be ready with your book and pencil. So, today's topic is collecting and representing data. Let us learn what is a pictorial representation now. Symbols and pictures can be used to represent data. This is known as pictorial representation. See children, instead of using numbers, we can also use pictures and symbols to represent something. That is known as pictorial representation. So, with the pictorial representation, we can understand the data easily. Let us see an example for pictorial representation now. Look at the picture and fill the required data. What can you see in the picture? We can see a train. So in the train, many compartments are there. So the first one is the engine, which is red in color. Next to engine, there is a compartment. In that compartment, we can find three lions. And the next compartment, we can see five tigers. Next to that, we can see three monkeys, and in the next one, two elephants, and in the last compartment, there are four giraffes. So, we can find lions, three lions, five tigers, three monkeys, two elephants, and four giraffes. So, now let's see the answer for given questions. First question, how many lions are there? Where did you find the lion? We found lion in the very first compartment. Next to the engine, there was a compartment. In that, we found the lion. How many lions were there? There are three lions. Second question, how many monkeys are there? So, in the third compartment, there were monkeys. Three monkeys. So, the answer is three. Circle the animal which is more in count. So, there are three lions, five tigers, three monkeys, two elephants and four giraffes. So, which is more? Tigers are more. So, circle tiger. Tiger has been circled. Tiger is the answer. Fourth question. Circle the animal which is less in count. There are only two elephants. So, elephants count is less. So, the answer is elephant. Fifth question. What is the difference between highest and lowest count? Difference means you need to subtract, you need to minus. So, among all, which one is highest? Tiger is highest. Which one is lowest? Elephants are the lowest. So, tiger 5 minus elephant 2. 5 minus 2, we get answer 3. So, the answer is 3. Sixth question. Total number of animals in zoo train is, what is the total number of animals in zoo train? Three lions, five tigers, three monkeys, two elephants and four giraffes. 3 + 5 + 3 + 2 + 4, we get totally 17 animals. Next comes another example. The following picture represents the data on fruits sold in a shop. What are the fruits sold? Let us see the fruits now. Apples, oranges, bananas and pineapples. Let us count how many were sold in each of those fruits. How many apples were sold? By counting the number of apple pictures, we can find 9 apples were sold. And oranges, 5 oranges, 10 bananas and 7 pineapples. Look at the above picture and fill required data. First question, name the fruit which was sold more. Among all the fruits, the count of banana is high because there were 10 bananas sold. So, the answer is banana. Second question, name the fruit which is sold less. Which is sold very less? It is oranges because there were only 5 oranges sold. The answer is already given. Third question, find the number of apples sold. How many apples were sold? Look at the picture and say, by counting the number of apples, it is 9. Fourth question, write the number of bananas sold. How many bananas were sold? 10 bananas. Fifth question, what is the difference in number of pineapples sold and oranges sold? Difference means you have to subtract, you have to minus. So number of pineapples minus number of oranges. How many pineapples? 7. Minus number of oranges? 5. 7 minus 5 in 7 lines. When you cut 5 lines, you get remaining 2. So the answer is 2. 7 minus 5, 2. Next is a practice. Collect data from 40 of your friends about their favorite food and represent it in picture. So it is your homework. Second question, the following picture represents the number of chocolates sold at a shop in a week. See children, it is given one toffee picture indicates 10 chocolates. So one toffee is 10 chocolates. So let us see the table now. In Monday, they were given 5 toffees. So 1 toffee means 10 chocolate. 5 toffees means 50 chocolates. Tuesday, there are 3 toffees given. So 30. Wednesday, 2 toffees given. So 20. Thursday, 4. So 40. Friday, again 3. So 30. Saturday, 1. So 1 toffee means 10. Answer the following questions from data given in above table. First question, the total number of chocolates sold on Thursday. Look at the picture and say how many chocolates were sold on Thursday. There are 40. Answer is 40. Second question, the sale was maximum on. Maximum means more. So by seeing the table, which one is more, 50 or 30 or 20 or 40 or 30 or 1? Which is high? 50 is high. So the answer is Monday. Monday only 50 toffees were, chocolates were sold. So answer is Monday. Third question, the sale was minimum on. Which is less? Look at the picture and say 10 is very less. So 10 is on Saturday. So answer is Saturday. Fourth question, sales were equal on. In which 2 days sales were same? See children, on Tuesday also 30, Friday also 30. So the answer is Tuesday and Friday. Fifth question, the total number of chocolates sold in 6 days are, total means you have to add all the 6 days. 50 plus 30 plus 20 plus 40 plus 30 plus 10. Totally we get 180 chocolates. So the next topic is drawing conclusion from represented data. Activity 4. Draw a conclusion from representation by discussing with your teacher. The graph below shows the number of children in a school studying in classes. Classes 1 to 4 of a school is given in a table. The number of girls studying in class 1 to 4 of a school are 14, 10, 16 and 13. So classes 1, 2, 3 and 4 are given. So the girls alone, total number of girls alone they have given. So boys, we need to discuss with your teacher and write. Draw the graph discussing with your teacher for number of boys. See, looking at the picture, number of girls are given. Boys, you have to write. For example, in class 1, consider there are 10 boys. They have given in class 1, there are 14 girls. You consider boys as 10. So what is the total number of students in class 1? 14 girls plus 10 boys. 14 plus 10, totally the answer is 24. So in class 1, 24 students are there. Same way, second standard girls, they have given 10 girls. Consider boys also 10. 10 plus 10, totally 20 students are there in second standard. Third standard, girls are given as 16. Consider there are 12 boys. Let us assume there are 12 boys. So 16 girls plus 12 boys. Totally the answer is 28. Class 4, it is given 13 girls. So consider boys as 14. Let us assume 14 boys are there. So 13 plus 14, totally 27 students are there in class 4. After completing pictorial representation, answer the following. So we have completed the pictorial representation. Class 1, 24 students. Class 2, 20 students. Class 3, 28 students. And class 4, 27 students. So let us answer for the questions given below. First question, the number of girls in class 2 is, see the table, look at class 2. See the girls alone, number of girls alone. Answer is 10. Second question, number of boys in class 3. See the table, third standard table. Look at the boys alone. So the number of boys is 12. Third question, total number of students in class 4. Look at the class 4 table. Total number of students means you have to add both boys and girls. So the total number of students is 27. Answer is 27. Fourth question, total number of girls from class 1 to 4. See children, you have to add the number of girls in classes 1, 2, 3 and 4. Only girls. So in class 1, 14 girls plus class 2, 10 girls. Plus class 3, 16 girls. Plus class 4, 13. 14 plus 10 plus 16 plus 13. Totally you get 53 girls. Fifth question. Total number of boys from class 1 to 4. Like the previous question, you have to add the number of boys alone. Class 1, 10 boys. Class 2, 10 boys. Class 3, 12 boys. Class 4, 14 boys. 10 plus 10 plus 12 plus 14, you get 46. There are 46 boys. Sixth question, the class which has more strength. Which class has more strength? Looking at the table, class 1 has 24, class 2, 20, class 3, 28, and class 4, 27. So 28 is more. 28 students are there in class 3. So the answer is class 3. The class which has more strength is class 3. So that's all about today's class, children. Coming to today's homework, practice first question, page number 81. Hope you all understood today's class. Thank you. Have a good day.